Thank God for allowing us to be here.
Yes, Lord.
Giving glory, honor, and praise unto the Lord for giving us an opportunity to come before Him, to lift Him up and to give Him praise, to repent and strive to get closer to Him.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. We thank God for our bishop while he's out in trouble. We pray that the Spirit of the Lord will continue to lead and guide him. Give him, Lord, give him mercy and grace, that is the edge of protection. Let it be a comfort around him. Minister to his mind and heart, and throughout his journey, bring him home safe. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Are you glad to be in the house of God?
Amen.
I say, are you glad to be in the house of God?
Amen.
Give him praise.
Amen.
Give God the praise. Because he is worthy to be praised. He is worthy of our highest praise. I want to talk to you tonight about godly counsel. I want to talk to you about the word called counsel or advice. We give a lot of advice . There's a lot of advice that goes on within ourselves at home, in our everyday life.
Amen.
And I want to talk to you today about advice and counsel. The Bible says, be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath.
Amen.
And we shall be judged by every word that proceeded out of our mouths. And we all do it. We have advice, but we want to be sure that the advice that we give is godly advice, godly counsel. Some advices come from the environment or the things that we're going through. Some advices or counsel is ungodly because it comes forth because of the influence of the enemy. And there's godly counsel. That gives us a lot of good and benefits. And so because we, as people, we give advice, we want to be sure that the advice that we give, amen, is godly and does not go against the scriptures. People seek advice in many different places. They go to palm readers. They go to different people. Sessions. For advice on how they should live or do things. And there are people who go back to the Word of God. to seek his face and to see what thus says the Lord. Amen. A good example. You have people who have go through a difficult time, for example, like in marriage. You have an abusive relationship, or you have a bad experience in marriage, and then when somebody wants to get married and needs your advice, because of your bad experiences, you turn around and say that you discourage them and talk bad about marriage when the Bible says that marriage is honorable in all things. Because of your personal experiences, but your personal experiences and the word, they're real, but the words that are coming out of your mouth are against the scriptures. Against the scriptures. When Job was in affliction, his wife came to him, seeing him sitting there after he had been afflicted by the devil. And she looked at him and said, Doest thou still hold your integrity? With everything that is going on, do you still retain your integrity? Why don't you curse your God and die? And Job looked at his wife and he said that thou speaketh as one that is foolish. Amen. She was speaking out of concern of what her husband was going through. But it was with the words that she was saying was against the scriptures, was against what Job knew about his own God. She said, "Do you still retain it? Why don't you curse your God and die?" And he said, "You speak as a foolish woman, because I can't curse my God and die." Can't curse my God and die. But she was speaking because of the things around her environment. But he went against the scriptures. Amen? Now, the Bible tells us to watch those who go against the scriptures, who go against the teaching, because they serve not the Lord Jesus Christ, but their own belly. And it says that through fair speeches, words, they will deceive the hearts of the simple. Here's the thing. A lot of times, people tend to gear towards things that sound good. Not sound teaching, but what sounds good. Let me hear what you have to say. And if it sounds good, or if it seems like it makes sense, people tend to lean towards that. But we're told to believe not every spirit, but try it to see whether it be of God or not. Try the spirit to see whether it be of God or not. Because there are many false prophets that have gone out into the world deceiving many. Amen? Now, the story of David. Now, David sinned against God with Bathsheba. And after he sinned and went through the trials that he went through in his own house, amen, there was a man named Shimei who cursed David. as he walked. And David was with one of young sons of Zeruiah, Abishai. And Abishai looked and he said, "Why don't you let me just go ahead and cut this man's head off?" And David said, "Let him curse. It could be that God will see my affliction, turn around and bless me." But what David was in his deathbed, he gave his son advice. He said, "Deal with him according to thy wisdom." After David died, Solomon called forth for Shimei. And he told him, "Go to Jerusalem, to the city. Build yourself a place there. Remain there." He was giving him his judgment. He said, "Build a place there and don't come out. Because the day that you do come out, you shall surely die." 1 Kings chapter 2. If you have your Bibles. 1 Kings chapter 2. Shimei thought this was good. Mercy. Judgment, not the judgment that you deserve. He got mercy. And he went into that city. He stayed there. For 3 years, he stayed there. While he was there, after 3 years, two of his servants escaped from him. And he went forth to find them. And word came back to Solomon saying that Shimei had left the city. Verse 36, do you have it? Verse 36, it said, "And the king sent and called for Shimei and said unto him, Build thee a house in Jerusalem and dwell there, and go not forth thence any whither. For it shall be that on the day thou goest out and passest over the brook, thou shalt know for certain that thou shalt surely die. Thy blood shall be upon thy own head." Shimei said unto the king, "The saying is good, as my lord the king has said, so will thy servant do." And Shimei dwelt in Jerusalem many days. And it came to pass at the end of 3 years that two of the servants of Shimei ran away unto Achish the son of Maker, king of Gath. And they told Shimei, saying, "Behold, my servants be in Gath." And Shimei rose and saddled his ass and went to Gath Achish and to seek his servants. And Shimei went and brought his servants from Gath. And it was told Solomon that Shimei had gone from Jerusalem to Gath and was come again. And the king sent and called for Shimei and said unto him, "Did I not make thee to swear by the word of the Lord, and protested unto the same? Know for a certain on the day that thou goest out and walkest abroad anywhither, that thou shalt surely die. And thou said unto me, the word that I have heard is good." That word right there, another definition for it is advice. He said out of his own mouth, "The advice that you gave me was good." Amen. Now, you can give people advice. You can receive advice, but it's no good if you don't apply it. You can give good advice and they leave from your presence and go do the exact opposite. Amen? How can you say it is good advice, it is good counsel, when you turn around and break it? Amen? If you get good advice and you agree to it and you say that it is good, and you receive it as a message that can help you, you have an obligation to keep it in righteousness. In righteousness. Because obedience has to go all the way. Not half the way or three quarters of the way, but it has to be all the way. God gives us word that can help us and carry us until the end. Because we don't want to be like Saul, who said, you told me to wait for 7 days, but you took a long time to get here. I waited for you 8. The 8th day you didn't show up. Therefore, I became presumptuous. Therefore, I became presumptuous. So it's important that when you do get good counsel, amen, to obey and keep it, it's got to be all the way. Amen? Now, 2 Samuel, just turn back a little bit, 26. No, 1 Samuel 26. First Samuel, actually chapter 25, is talking about Abigail. Now, Nabal was a wealthy man. And while David was out with his men in the field, they saw some of the men that were keeping the sheep. Nabal was a man that liked to do shearing. And David's men protected the men. So David sent some of his men and said, go to the house of Nabal and say, just give some of this young men just a little bit of food to eat. Verse 12 says, so this is when David sends them to Nabal's house. David's young men turned their way and went again and came and told him all those sayings. And David said unto his men, this is after they went to Nabal's house, and the previous verse 11, the Nabal turned around and says to the men, shall I then take my bread and my water and my flesh that I have killed for my shears and give it unto men whom I know not whence they be? And he was saying, who is this David? I'm just going to take the things that I have and just give it to just anybody. So when the man went back to David, David said unto the man, guard ye up on every man his sword. And they got it up, every man his sword, and David also on his sword. And they went up about 400 men, and 200 aboard the staff, but one of the young men told Abigail, Nabal's wife, saying, behold, David sent messengers out of the wilderness to salute our master, and he railed on them. And to clarify, she just wanted to know, did they really do what they say they did? Verse 16, it said, they were a wall unto us both by night and day, all the while we were with them, keeping the sheep. And verse 17 says, now therefore know and consider what thou wilt do. This is one of them telling Abigail, for evil is determined against our master and against all his household, for he is such a son of Belial that a man cannot speak to him. Verse 23. So they took the food, went on their way to meet David, because they got news that David was coming and he was going to destroy all of them for the sin of her husband. because he's the son of Belial. And when Abigail saw David, she hasted and lighted off the ass and fell before David on her face and bowed herself to the ground and fell on her feet and said, upon me, my Lord, upon me, let this iniquity be, and let thy handmaid, I pray thee, speak in thy audience and hear the words of the handmaid. Now, when you give godly advice, it's going to bring forth the fruits of the Spirit. Because again, she was considering everyone. Let not, my Lord, I pray thee, regard this man of Belial, even Nabal, for his name is, so is he. Nabal is his name, and folly is with him. But I, thy handmaid, saw not the young man of my Lord whom thou didst send. Now therefore, as the Lord liveth and the soul liveth, seeing the Lord has withholden thee from coming to shed blood and from avenging thyself with thy own hand, let thy enemies and they that seek evil to my Lord be as Nabal. And now this blessing which thy handmaid has brought unto my Lord, let it even be given unto the young man. I pray thee, forgive the trespass, for the Lord will certainly make my Lord a sure house, because my Lord fighteth the battles of the Lord. A soft answer turns away wrath, and evil has not been found in thee all thy days. He's talking to David, saying, listen, evil has not been found in thee all thy days, and you fight the battles of the Lord. Verse 30, it said, and it shall come to pass, when the Lord shall have done to my Lord according to all the good that he has spoken concerning thee, and shall have appointed thee ruler over Israel, that this shall be no grief unto thee. You don't want to have this on your record. You don't want to have this on your hands, not offense of heart, because you just reacted. Amen. For a man that can control his spirit is stronger than he that can take a whole city. Either that thou hast shed blood costless, and that my Lord has avenged himself, but when the Lord shall have dealt with thee, have dealt with my Lord, then remember the handmaid. And David said to Abigail, blessed be the God of Israel, which sent thee this day to meet me. And blessed be thy advice, and blessed be thou, which have kept me this day for coming to shed innocent blood, and from avenging myself with our own hand. Amen? Amen. Amen? Amen? Sometimes you see trouble coming. Sometimes you see trouble coming, and you can do something about it. Amen? Sometimes you can see trouble coming, and sometimes God will put it upon you, amen, to do something to save the rest of the people. The lot can fall on you. If you don't do something, they all get destroyed. But if you knew you could have done something, you could have just given a few words. Because all she did is give just a few words that turned away the wrath of David. We despise not prophecy, but prove all things. Amen. If it's good, it doesn't matter where it comes from. Amen. If it's good, you gotta eat it. Because God will use whomsoever he will. God will use whomsoever he will. And it might be you at that particular time to save the rest of the people. just like he did with Esther, with the Jews. Her bravery saved the Jews from the evil that was coming from Mordecai. Sometimes it could fall on you to do something. And when it does, you have to, amen, by the word of the Lord, let him lead and guide you. He said, blessed be the advice. Because we don't know what would have happened if David had gone down and destroyed all those people. But she kept him from shedding blood. Amen?
Amen.
Now, during the time when David had sinned, and Absalom, amen, tried to take over the kingdom, he had followers with him. Now, David's right-hand man, his name was Ahithophel, went, followed after Absalom. When David found out that Ahithophel, his right-hand man, had turned on him, he went and just said a simple prayer. Lord, you see, Ahithophel's wisdom was as God was talking to you. His wisdom was like God's. So David said a simple prayer because he knew when he was in trouble, when Ahithophel turned on him. He said, let his counsel be turned into foolishness. And so David sent one of his men, Hushai. He said, go and find out and just see what counsel that Ahithophel is going to be giving him. And so Absalom looked at Ahithophel and he said, what do you suggest that I do? This was the man that told Absalom, amen, to lay down with all of David's wife in daylight. Amen. This was the man that told him, go ahead, you know, spread the tent, lay with all his wives, and he's gonna make you strong. He's gonna make you strong. After that happened, still looking for counsel from Ahithophel, see, when he saw Hushai come, he tried to figure out why you're here. He said, listen, you're gonna be the king, then you're the one I'm going to follow. But God has allowed this to happen to turn the counsel of Ahithophel. So he looked at Ahithophel and he said, what do you suggest I should do? And Ahithophel said, you know, let's encamp David's camp throughout the night, and then we'll scare his men, and then I'll go down and kill him. Amen. So after that, then Absalom looked at Hushai and he said, what do you think I should do? And Hushai said, you know your man, you know your father, he's a man of war. That is not a good advice that he just told you. You should go to battle yourself. When Ahithophel found out that his counsel had not been received, had not been followed, he went back to his house, got his house in order, and hung himself. Now, Absalom, you have people who will go around trying to find out from everybody, unsure about themselves, and will go around trying to find advice from everybody. Go to mama, what do you think I should do? Maybe you should pursue this, maybe you should go buy this, you go ahead and do this. I think this will be good for you. You head in that direction, you'll be okay. The next day, to the best friend, what do you think? She's telling me do this, but what do you think? You tell them something, then they turn around and go to another person. What do you think I should do? 2 Samuel chapter 17. Verse 14, and Absalom and all the men of Israel. And all said, the counsel of Hushai the Archite is better than the counsel of Ahithophel. For the Lord had appointed the defeat, the counsel of Ahithophel, to the intent that the Lord might bring evil upon Absalom. Then he said to Hushai, and to Abiathar the priest, thus and thus did Ahithophel counsel Absalom and the elders of Israel, and thus have I counseled. Now therefore, send quickly and tell David, say, lodge not that night. Amen. The Lord had allowed it to the intent that the Lord might bring evil upon Absalom. The advice that they received, the Lord had allowed it for their own destruction. Amen. Amen. The Lord had allowed it for their own destruction. Now there's some Psalms chapter 1. It says, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the council. Blessed is the man that does not walk in the advice of the ungodly. Amen. You can't walk in the advice of the ungodly because they don't know God. Blessed is the man that does not walk in the counsel of the ungodly, but his delight, your delight should be in the law of God, and in the law of God you need to meditate day and night, and you shall be as a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. Your delight should be in the law of God. There are many deceivers that have gone out there. You can't buy everything that's put on your table. Can't buy everything that's presented to you. In Jeremiah, it says there's a terrible thing in the land. The prophets prophesy by their own rule. The priest by their own, and the people love it. Paul said, be instant in season and out. Because people will, in the last days, they will not endure sound teaching. They just want to hear watered down doctrine. Anything that sounds good. Having itching ears. Having itching ears. But in Revelation, we're going to finish with that. It says, buy of me, I counsel you, buy of me gold tried in the fire. You think you stand? Let me show you. Revelation chapter 3. We'll close with that. Revelation chapter 3. verse 18. Verse 14, it says, "And to the angel of the church of the Laodiceans write, this thing said the Amen, the faithful and witness, beginning of the creation of God. I know thy works, that thou art neither cold or hot. I would that thou art cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold or hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth. Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods, and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable and poor and blind and naked, I counsel thee to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich." He said, "I do a self-examination. You think you stand? I'll give you some advice. Buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich, white raiment, that thou mayest be clothed, and that the shame of thy nakedness do not appear, and anoint the eyes with eyesore, that thou mayest see." Self-examination. Because we don't stand as we ought. He said, if you think you stand, amen, buy of me gold tried in the fire, and you're going to find out that you don't stand as you ought. Godly counsel. Buy of me gold tried in the fire. Do a self-examination that you may see where you stand. Because we don't always stand as we ought. Because you think you stand, go through some fiery trials to see where your faith stands. The godly counsel. Walk not after the counsel of the ungodly. Amen. Just encourage us. Be swift to hear, slow to speak. Because counsel is important advice. We give it all the time. All the time. All the time. When Rehoboam became king, before he could serve the people said, "Your father put upon us heavy yokes. Make him light and we will serve you." That's all. Want to be great? You got to serve. He said, "Give me 3 days." Went and consulted with the old man. And the old man said, "Do as they say. They'll be your servants forever." Went to his young buddies. And they say, "What do you think?" His friend says, "Make the yoke even heavier." They were young. Said, "Make it heavier." When he came back, he responded to the people roughly. Talk to the people. God's people, just any kind of way. Spoke to them roughly. Wonder why they all went the other way. They all went the other way. Called for Jeroboam, made him king. And instead of him taking responsibility, he gathered a few men and said, "Listen, Rehoboam trying to take up, you know, trying to take these other kingdoms. We're going to go beat him up for something that God gave him." Before they left, God sent a prophet and said, everybody go home. Don't fight your brethren. Yeah. Don't fight your own brothers. Amen. Go home. And they went home, and Jeroboam became king. But the people used to have to, but they left. Rehoboam was still the king over Jerusalem, and so that's where the people used to go and worship. And we all know the story. He felt like, you know, if they go, they won't come back. Amen. So he made him worship false gods because of his own insecurities for something that God gave him. But if we live according to his word, amen, if the words that we speak life, not just any old thing, they just speak life, godly counsel, based on God's word, then you don't have to worry about taking it back. Amen? And if you give advice, you better be able to stand with whatever happens after that. You want to give advice, and when things go wrong, you're the first one to run the other way. But the howling, say, hey, listen, you know, you look back, and you're like, you told me to do this, and they look back, they are not there when it hits the fan. No, you got to be able to stand. If I give you the advice, I need to be able to stand there and help you fix it. Because I told you to go in that direction. That's why it's important that what we, the counsel that we give, won't be sure they can carry him. Because if it's in God's word, it will stand. Amen. Even if there's trouble in the beginning, it all work out for the good. It will all work out for the good. Because it's God's word. Never said it would be easy. Straight, narrow. Maybe a little difficult. But it will work out for your good. It will work out for your good. Godly counsel always. Give godly counsel, not based on your feelings, not based on the trials that you're going through, but based on the word of the Lord. For we shall be judged by every word that proceeded out of our mouth. Be swift to hear, slow to speak. And if you receive it, and if it sees his word, amen, you have an obligation to abide all the way. All the way. Amen. Let's lift up holy hands all over the sanctuary. Hallelujah. He's a prayer answering God. Pray.